Hey, what's going on everybody, and welcome back for another bite-sized little mod review. Today we're checking out a pretty new mod, and that's going to be Basic Mashups by Spider Babes. And this mod is a really cool one. This adds a bunch of new armors into the game, all of which are very, very lore friendly as they use all in-game assets. And these are mods that I enjoy a lot. It's a big reason why I use Clothing of the Commonwealth. It takes the in-game assets, mashes them up with other in-game assets to make outfits that you would totally see. Rather than the same t-shirt and jeans over and over again, now you get some cool variation, which is really, really nice. I like mods like this a lot. Now, this is a fairly new mod. The author says that they were playing around the outfit studio and came up with a few outfits they enjoyed, and so they decided to release them to us, which is super cool. The biggest downside for me at this moment is that there is no leveled list integration. Right now, you can only craft these at the chemistry station under the new basic mashup section. However, these are still some really cool outfits, so it may fit your character pretty well. But I know there's going to be another downside for some of you guys out there, and that is that these outfits, at the moment, are female only. When I tried to equip them to my male character, it instead gave a generic Institute outfit rather than any of the outfits that are seen here. So, for the moment, these are female only. But maybe at some point in the future there will be some male alternatives, or maybe even some leveledless integration, or who knows, maybe somebody else will patch that in. Only time will tell, but at the moment, this is what you get. Let's go ahead and go in-game, check out the chemistry station, and see what all we can craft, as well as what all of the new outfits look like. So, once you are in-game, go ahead and get to the chemistry station, scroll down, and you will find the new basic mashups category. From there, we have a handful of new outfits. So, first we have the armored corset, which is going to give us some pretty decent stats. We have 25 damage resistance, 10 poison, 5 energy, and 5 radiation, along with a bonus endurance of 1. Pretty cool. Then we have the basic vest, which has 15 damage resistance, 10 poison, 5 energy, and 5 radiation, and then a charisma of plus 1. The casual raider gives you 15 damage resistance, 5 poison, 5 energy, 5 radiation, and a charisma modifier of 2. The cozy vault dweller gives you a damage resistance of 20, poison of 10, energy 5, and radiation 5, and another bonus endurance of 1. The fancy raider gives you 20 damage, 10 poison, 5 energy, 5 radiation, and then plus 2 charisma. The hunter jeans gives you 20 damage, 10 poison, 5 energy, 5 radiation, 1 endurance, and 1 perception. Then we have hunter jeans sleeveless, which is going to be exactly the same with just a different mesh and texture. And then the Inquisitive Adventurer gives you 20 damage, 10 poison, 5 energy, 5 radiation, and 1 endurance. I really like all of these, some pretty decent stats, different from the vanilla armor sets, as well as giving those bonus modifiers, much like classic Fallout outfits. Really like these a lot. Now we're going to take these and check them out one by one. Here we first have the armored corset, which is going to be the corset that you normally see Kate wearing, along with some armor thrown around on the arms and legs. This one looks really, really cool. Then we have the basic vest, which is going to use the t-shirt and jeans, and then also throw a vest on top. So a little bit more casual than the standard vests in the game. This would be good for maybe a bartender at a settlement. Then we have the casual raider. I like this outfit. It looks like something that you would have found in previous Fallout games, similar to, say, the doctor outfit, stuff like that. With a bloody tank top and some cargo pants, this one looks really, really cool. Definitely feels like a Fallout outfit. Then we have the cozy vault dweller. No outfit pack is complete with some take on the vault outfit. So Tiz takes the vault suit, adds a nice little coat on top to keep you warm, and then some really high socks as well as some Converse down below, all matching the vault suit colors. This is actually a pretty neat outfit. Really cool. Now for the more extravagant of you, we have the fancy raider, which offers a nice corset with the big coat, as well as some raider jeans, chains, and some pouches. So this is still viable in a combat situation, just with a little bit more style. Now we move on to another really cool outfit, the hunter jeans. Now this is one where I beg the question, why is it not available for male characters? Because this is a really cool outfit. Takes a Longfellow's coat, tucks it into some jeans, and you just have a really nice survivor's style outfit. This some really cool utility. We've got a knife and some pouches, as well as the bullets on our chest. Definitely don't see why this couldn't be made for both genders. On the flip side of that, we have the hunter jeans sleeveless, which is the exact same outfit, just missing the sleeves. Nothing is different beyond that, and all the stats are identical, but in case it's a little too warm in your Commonwealth, you can use this instead. Then finally, we have the Inquisitive Adventurer, which will give you what I believe is the Surveyor outfit top, with some short shorts as well as an armored leg. Pretty interesting, definitely a survivor's outfit, although not much in the way of leg protection, so definitely an interesting one, but still cool to have the option. And that is the basic mashups pack. Definitely, like I said, would love to see some leveled list integration, as well as some male versions of at least some of these outfits. I know some of these may be a little odd, like the corsets and such, but definitely would be cool to see it go both ways. Either way, this is a great mod. Definitely some really cool outfits in here for female characters, so if you play a female character and you're okay with crafting them at the workbench, these are really, really cool. Or even just downloading this for some of your female settlers is a great idea as well. Just because you can't use them doesn't mean that your settlers can't. Definitely a cool one and worth checking out. If you would like to try this for yourself, the link will be in the description as always. And don't forget to go out there and support your mod authors. They do put a lot of work into these mods and they do it for free. So go out there and show your support. If you enjoyed their mods, endorse it the next time you visit the Nexus and consider donating if that's something you're able to do. And above all, just show them your appreciation for all of their hard work. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to drop a rating. Subscribe if you haven't already for more videos just like this. And I hope to see you in the next one. Peace. And hey, shout out to all of our patrons for their continued support. As always, your donations are greatly appreciated and help to fund videos just like this one. So, again, thank you.